We all are familiar with the CIP rule, that is the can-in-gold prelog priority rule for assigning absolute configurations to chiral centers. Now this CIP system is even more valuable because it can be extended to cover situations in which no chiral center is present, that is the situations which contain chiral axis or chiral planes. Here we are going to concentrate our discussions only to chiral axis. For example, let us consider a tetrahedral arrangement of ligands around a chiral center. For this, we are going to consider a regular tetrahedron with four different vertices, that is the four different ligands A, B, C and D. As all the four ligands are different, so the system does not contain any chiral plane of symmetry. So the system is chiral with a chiral center or a stereogenic center. Now, if we grasp opposite edges of this tetrahedron, let's say B and C, let us grasp B and C and stretch them, the chiral center is extended into the chiral axis. As you can see, we are grasping B and C, and then it gets the chiral center, the tetrahedron first gets extended and eventually the chiral center gets extended to the chiral axis. Now generally, such an elongated tetrahedron has less symmetry than a regular tetrahedron, and hence the condition of its dissymmetrization is less stringent. The structure remains dissymmetric, lacking a plane of symmetry. So now this molecule is an example of chiral axis, and it is viewed in a, that is projected along a perpendicular plane. Now this molecule will remain chiral so long as A should not be equals to B, that is A should not be equal to B and C should not be equals to D. Now this condition is a compulsory condition. Now considering that condition along with the fact even if A remains equal to C or B remain equals to D, then also the molecule chiral, the provided A should not be equals to B and C should not be equals to D, that is the molecule should not contain any plane of symmetry. Now these molecules generally are present in the point group CN and DN. We are not discussing anything about the point groups or symmetry, so let us consider only the fact how to assign absolute configuration to the chiral axis. So the chief representatives of these point groups are alenes, this is an alene, biphenyl and spiro compounds. These are three classes of the molecules which possess chiral axis. Now, we need to extend the CIP rules in order to assign absolute configuration to the chiral axis. We are not including the CIP rules here, as you can generally read these rules from any textbook. We are just providing the extra rules that it in order to assign the absolute configuration. Going to the first rule, the molecule is viewed along the chiral axis. Second rule states the near ligands take precedence over the far ligands. And the third rule states that the ligands of lowest priority is ignored. Now we will be going in details of these three rules one by one with the examples in the following slides. And gradually you will understand the three rules and how to apply them. So now going to the first example, we are considering a biphenyl A and its enantiomer, that is the mirror image, B. So this biphenyl has got a chiral axis. This red dotted line is a chiral axis. So the chiral axis is the axis about which a set of substituents like NO2, CO2H, CO2NO2 are held in a spatial arrangement. So as you can see, these substituents are held in a specific spatial arrangement about this chiral axis. And this molecule should not be superimposable on its mirror image about the chiral axis. Okay. Going to the next slide, we are considering the first example of the biphenyl system. Now this is a chiral axis. The molecule is viewed along the chiral axis. So we are viewing the molecule from the left side about this chiral axis. Now let us hold this chiral axis and bring it in front of us such that this horizontal plane appears as a horizontal line in front of us with the groups NO2 and CO2H, and this vertical plane, that is vertical phenyl ring, appears as a straight vertical line, okay, which is perpendicular to the horizontal one with the groups NO2 and CO2H. This is the 3D image of this biphenyl ring on now, as I told you, doing hold this chiral axis, bring it in front of you, okay, we can see that this NO2 comes here, this CO2H goes here, this is the horizontal phenyl ring, this is the chiral axis, this is the vertical phenyl ring, this is NO2 is present above the plane, horizontal plane, this CO2H is present below the horizontal plane. So you can visualize this very clearly here. Okay, now going to the second enantiomer, okay, this is the chiral axis. It is viewed from the left hand side. Holding the chiral axis, if we bring it in front of us, we see that this phenyl ring is present in the perpendicular plane, is closer to us, and this phenyl ring, which is present in the horizontal plane, is behind us. So accordingly, we place the ligands NO2 and CO2H is above and below the plane respectively, and NO2 and CO2H are present farther away from us. Now if we view the structures from the left and project them onto the perpendicular plane like this, this is the first enantiomer, and place the ligands as given there. And according to the CIP rule, number one rule, we viewed these molecules from the left hand side. According to number two rule, the near ligands are more prior to the farther away ligands. Okay, so accordingly we number these ligands 1 to 4. So NO2 is more important than the CO2H according to the CIP rule. And then we go to the ligands which are farther away from us and number them 3 and 4 respectively. The fourth ligand is ignored, and on going from 1 to 3, the direction that is cut is anticlockwise. So the absolute configuration that we put over here is S. Now moving to the second enantiomer. So here, after putting the ligands and following the CIP rule, we number NO as 1 and CO2 as 2 as they are closer to us, and then moving to the ligands that are farther away from us, we put NO2 as 3 and CO2H as 4. Now neglecting the fourth ligand, on going from 1 to the direction that is covered is clockwise direction. So the configuration that we assign to this enantiomer is R. Now note that the application of the near greater than far rule means that the CO2H on the front ring takes precedence over the NO2 on the rear ring. That is, the CO2H of the front ring takes precedence over the NO2 of the the backward of the ring. It may seem that this result could be related to our choosing to view the molecule from the left, but this is not so. Here, in the following pages, we shall see that the projections obtained if we view this from the right side, then the configurations obtained are same. This is the first mark. When we view this molecule along the chiral axis from the right hand side, putting, holding this chiral axis, moving in front of us, we observe that this vertical phenyl ring is appear as a vertical line closer to us with the NO2 and CO2H closer to us, and this is the phenyl ring which is present farther away from us with NO2 and CO2H present accordingly. This is the 3D image. This is the chiral axis. This is the vertical plane. NO2 is above the plane. CO2 is just below the plane. Here NO2 is present to the right hand side and CO2 is present on the left hand side. Then we go to the number these ligands according to the CIP rule. NO2 is 1. CO2 is 2. These are closer to us. Then we go to the ligands that are farther away from us and number NO2 as 3 and CO2 as 4. Then on moving from 1 to 3, the direction that is covered is anti-clockwise. So the absolute configuration of this enantiomer is S. Okay, now let's move on to the next enantiomer. We are going to view this molecule from the right hand side along the chiral axis. Accordingly, the phenyl ring, which is in the horizontal plane, is closer to us, so it is present right in front of us as a horizontal line. And the phenyl ring that is in the vertical plane is farther away from us, so it is present as a vertical line behind the first horizontal line. Accordingly, we put all the ligands and then number them according to the CIP rule. The closer ligands get priority over the farther ligands, and hence after numbering we move from 1 to 3 in the clockwise direction. And hence the configuration that we assign to this molecule is R configuration. Now going to the next class of compounds, alenes are the next class of compounds. The alenes are considered to be chiral if the substituents on each terminus are different. Similar condition as that for the stereoisomerism in alkanes. This is the chiral axis. On viewing this molecule from the left hand side along the chiral axis, we consider the this portion as a vertical plane and it is closer to us, and this portion as the horizontal plane which is farther away from us. Phenyl ring is above and hydrogen is below the plane of the chiral axis, and hydrogen is present in the left hand side and pH is present in the right hand side of the plane that is farther away from us. This is the 3D image. Similarly, we observe the pH and age is above and below the plane, and pH and age is in the right and the left hand side respectively. After numbering following the CIP rule, we observe that on moving from 1 to 3, the direction that is covered is anticlockwise, and hence the absolute configuration of this molecule is S. Spiro compounds are yet another group of molecules in which ligands remote from the spiro junction, this is the ligand, these are the remote ligands from the spiro junction, can be placed in a stretched tetrahedral arrangement. So this is the chiral axis. On viewing it from the left hand side, we observe that age and beer, this is in the horizontal plane and it is closer to us, and this age and beer is in the vertical plane which is farther away from. So BR is present in the right hand side, age is in the left hand side, and similar way age and BR is above and below the plane respectively. This is the 3D image. Now after numbering and following the CIP rule, on moving from 1 to 3, the direction that is covered is anticlockwise, and hence the absolute configuration of this molecule is S. Finally, a very unusual example, that is a biphenyl in which two identical bridges maintain a twisted structure. This is very unusual compound. So, and this is the chiral axis, and we are viewing this molecule from the left hand side. And on viewing this molecule, this portion is in front of us. Then from there, it is joined to the rear end in a similar way. This is the 3D image of the molecule. This is the chiral axis, as you can see. Okay, so now this is joined from S like in this manner. You can view this very well. In this case, we arbitrarily choose either front substituent as 1. This is considering this to be 1. Then the rear group bonded to 1, that is this 1, becomes 3. Similarly, this becomes 2 and this becomes 4. On going from 1 to 3, the direction covered is clockwise and hence the configuration obtained is R. I tried to explain few common examples of axial chirality. If you have any queries, then please comment in the comment box below. If you want me to present any other chemistry topics before you, then please mention them in the comment box. Thank you very much. If you liked this video, then please hit the like button below and please don't forget to subscribe to this channel.